We know Neanderthals were a parallel group of humans who went extinct tens of thousands of years ago, but what if before it happened, they asked us for help? Howdy humans, Trace here for DNews. How can you not find a story about Neanderthals riveting? New research published in PLOS ONE examined a 60,000 year old Neanderthal hyoid bone and found our human cousins were likely able to speak. The hyoid bone is situated right below the jaw and it's attached via muscles and ligaments to the larynx, pharynx, epiglottis, and the floor of the mouth. It's the only bone in the human body not attached to any other bone, and its main function is to anchor the tongue. Around 300,000 years ago, a baby Homo heidelbergensis was born with its hyoid bone slightly lower than most. It was attached to the larynx, which allowed this baby a lot more control of both its tongue and larynx as it grew up. The larynx, by the way, usually known as the voice box. Fish, amphibians, reptiles, mammals, birds, all have hyoid bones, but only the Homo heidelbergensis had this weird dropping mutation. Both Neanderthal and human descended from the heidelbergensis, us in Africa and them in Europe. All of this has been known for a while, but though the Neanderthal had a similar hyoid bone, it wasn't until recently that scientists could show that they had enough brains to make a language. Researchers used new 3D X-ray imaging technology to scan a 60,000-year-old hyoid bone and created a computer model. The model revealed not only the external similarity to modern humans, but also how the internal structures were formed and shaped by the bone's use. The kicker? The Neanderthal bone is indistinguishable from a modern human's, indicating it is highly likely that they used it the same way, which means Neanderthals could talk. This pushes language development in humanoids even farther into the past. It's been shown by paleontological and anthropological studies before that Neanderthals had art, they had tools, they built houses, they formed communities, they even had religion and buried their dead. But this was the strongest evidence yet that this was all done accompanied with verbal language. When the Homo sapien arrived from Africa, we could also speak too, obviously. Though with a smaller skull and wider, shorter noses than the Neanderthal, our speech patterns were likely stronger and more varied. Evolving in warm, sunny Africa, the Homo sapien was better adapted for life on our planet with smaller eyes and a more evolved frontal cortex. The large eyes and bodies of the Neanderthal couldn't really keep up with the Homo sapien. We traveled in larger community groups than the Neanderthal and either absorbed or destroyed their population as we spread across Europe and Asia. Regardless of which one, though, there are different theories. Every year, more evidence comes out that these Neanderthals weren't just mindless cavemen brutes, but were a parallel culture of evolving beings. Not only were we all talking sooner, but we were perhaps a little more similar than we once believed, which makes the history of these ancient people even more intriguing. I wonder if the ancient Neanderthal and Homo sapien, like, talked to each other? You think there were translators? I mean, we know we interbred and we lived at the same time, so what do you think? Share your musings below and make sure you subscribe. Thank you to everyone who gives us a like and shares us with your friends. You are all awesome. Thanks for watching, everybody.